They're definitely the best speakers that I have ever owned, but there's a few issues that have concerned me. Yo, guys, what's happening? What's going on? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to the vlog, and man, am I excited for today? If you guys have been following the vlog, you guys know that I recently went speaker shopping. And well, after demoing many different speakers from many different manufacturers, I have settled on the JBL SRX 815Ps. And today's video is special because today we are going to be not only unboxing the speakers, but also doing a demo. So I hope that you guys are as excited as I am about checking out the JBL SRX 815Ps. So here we are, guys. These are it. These are the JBL SRX 815. Let's get inside of these bad boys. Oh, this box was so strong that it actually bent my knife. Inside of the box, we do have some sort of instruction manual, and also you do get a certificate with your warranty. Inside of the box, you also get your power cords, and there's something a little bit different about these because these IEC cables or power cable are actually locking IEC. So you guys see that there? Focus right here. See this little button right here? And that's to prevent your speakers from losing power. Another cool thing that I love right off the bat is the fact that they actually gave you a nice long cable. Many of you guys know I'm a 4'10" individual, so this is around 5 feet right here, and you also have like another 3 feet of slack. I wanna say 8-10 feet of power. Wow, so this is it, guys, the JBL SRX powered speakers. I can already tell you this, they are a lot heavier than the PRX lines that I did have. We're talking about maybe a 15-20 pound difference. These are about 65 pounds as opposed to the PRX 715s, which were only about, I wanna say, 45-50 pounds. They got some weight to them. With the SRX line, well, basically there's 5 total speakers in the line. Starting off with their full range, there's 3 full range speakers. They have their 12, their 15, which is this one right here, right smack dab in the middle. There's also a 15 inch 3-way, which is a step above this one. The reason I didn't get that is because the 3-ways are huge. We're talking about 2 speakers basically in one. And in the sub line, we have 2. We have an 18 and a dual 18. I actually wanted to get a dual 18 if you guys saw the video when I was shopping for these. Let's bring you guys in a little closer and talk about the specs. All right, so let's talk about the build quality of this bad boy. You hear that? That is 14 gauge steel on the grill right here. And if you look at it, it's got kind of like a honeycomb, kind of like a beehive kind of look. I also love this little ribbit. Or you, of course, have handles on either side as well. You have a handle here, a handle on here as well, and a handle on top. I'm gonna try to lift this. Probably gonna get a hernia lifting it because these bad boys are no joke. Whoa. Speakers feature a wooden enclosure. You hear that? 18 millimeter wooden enclosure. And it also features their Duraflex coating. Now with this one, I am not too sure if this is the same one that they had on the PRXs. Hoping that the coating on this one is a little bit better than what I had on my old PRXs. Again, this is a more expensive speaker, so I'm hoping that that's true because these black speakers are prone to scratches. The speaker also features rubber stoppers on both the side of the speaker right here, boom, boom, so that you can use this as a monitor if you want to put this on the ground. Rubber feet on the bottom. Oh, these are heavy. I'm gonna get a hernia. Rubber feet on the bottom as well as the side. Let's take a look at the back of the speaker and talk about what it's all about. So let's start up here at the top. You of course have some vents for ventilation to make sure that your speaker always stays nice and cool. Power button is actually a button. I'm not sure how I feel about that. I'm kind of a fan of the switch on and off. You have an LCD screen right here, and you also have a master level and also your navigation for the menus inside of this LED right here. Back button for when you're scrolling through the menu system inside of the LCD. This also clicks, so if you push this volume knob, it also works as kind of like your enter button. Moving down, we have your inputs and outputs. You have your inputs, of course, channel 1 and channel 2, which are dual XLR and quarter inch inputs. So you can go right in with a quarter inch or an XLR as you please. And then, of course, you have your volume knobs here, channel 1, channel 2. You have your network connection or Ethernet connection, whatever you want to call it. You can kind of go inside of the speaker via network to kind of mess around with the EQs and pretty much acts like a drive rack to mess around with the settings inside of the speaker. I'm personally not a fan of doing that, but I do know that there are guys that love going in and tweaking the sound to get it just to their liking. I'm not a fan of doing that. If you do want to connect to it, you have to plug in a router and then connect to that router. Download the app on your Android or iOS device and then start messing with it. So it's not something that you can just plug and play. You do need a router if you do want to access this kind of feature, if you will. Not a fan of it, not a fan of it at all. Let's push this back a little bit. Let's talk a little bit about what's inside of the speakers. Started with JBL's transducer. I was watching a video about that and they actually said that they manufacture custom premium transducers just for this line of speakers. The speaker is powered by a crown amp featuring their drive core technology blasting, get ready for this, a whopping 2000 watts. Max output, we're talking about 103 dB. On the bottom of the speaker, it features your standard 35 millimeter pole mounts, and you have two of them. One is for straight up, and the other one is kind of angling the speaker down. All right, now you know the specs, you know what it's built of. Let's see if JBL delivered on this speaker. Let's do a demo. Now, just a quick disclaimer, it is impossible to show you the sound quality of speakers via a video because essentially you're hearing the camera, you're not actually hearing the speakers. Highly recommend that if you're going to make an investment like this, we're talking almost a $3,000 investment, so I highly recommend that you actually go out to a speaker shop and preview them for yourself. So let's set it up and test these bad boys out. I am excited. Let's take a chance.
Con otro pasas el rato. Vamos a ser feliz, vamos a ser feliz, feliz en los cuatro.
So that video that you just saw was actually from about 6 months ago when I first bought the SRX speakers, and I want to share with you guys what I think about them after bringing them out to real world events. I've brought them out to all different kind of events, and I think I've made my conclusion and am ready to share my thoughts with you guys. First off, let me just say that these are awesome speakers. They're definitely the best speakers that I have ever owned, but there's a few issues that have concerned me. The number one issue with these speakers that's everyone's complaint who I've had come work with me is the weight. These speakers are insanely heavy. 65 pounds may not sound like a lot, but trust me, when you're trying to get it up on these tripods, it is no easy task. It is very, very heavy to the point where you usually need two people, one on each handle, to actually get it up. Also, I did have to go out and buy a different set of tripods, and I have one of the best tripods in the industry. I have Frankenstands. I had to go out and get the Frankenstands F2, which can hold 50 pounds or higher. Trust me when I say this, a regular tripod is going to be holding on for dear life holding this speaker up. Second issue that I have is actually not with the speaker itself, but with the brand, JBL. So when I bought these speakers, I also bought the case. Now, the case that they sent me came directly from JBL because it wasn't in stock at the store. And when the case came in, came directly from JBL, and the case came in broken. I contacted JBL and they did nothing about it. And both of the cases came in like this, with faulty stitching. Look at this. It's supposed to be stitched across, but as you guys can see, it's hanging on for dear life, and both of the cases have the exact same issue. The cases came in faulty. It's been 6 months since I reported it, and I have yet to receive replacement cases. They pretty much shoved it under the bus. And that just speaks volumes about the company. Like, what the hell? You can't even replace a freaking case. I'm not even asking for a spare. I'm willing to send that one back if they send me a new one, but they have not sent me a replacement case, and that just blows my mind. They keep saying that they're gonna send it, and it never came. Never came, and that just makes me really disappointed, especially with something so mediocre like a case. You gotta check the stitching. You gotta stay on top of quality control. Now, aside from that, sound quality, best speakers that I have ever owned, like I mentioned, they freaking bump. This is a pro line speaker. This is not for somebody that's considering DJing. This is for pros. I'm bringing these out every weekend and they have not failed me. They pack a punch. They give you a nice full sound. Bass is awesome. Highs are awesome. It's just an overall pleasing sound and I love it. I don't regret making the purchase. However, the weight and the bag situation really kind of sours the taste in my mouth a little bit. If you were to ask me, would I recommend this speaker? If you're just a basic mobile DJ and you're not doing anything crazy, probably not. The retail price of this speaker is $2,000. It's since gone down, so you could probably get a really good deal now because the speakers are kind of old now. You could probably get two of these for about $3,000. That is still a very big investment. Honestly, if you're on the fence between the JBL PRXs and the JBL SRXs, I would probably go with the PRX route. Now, the jump in build quality, aesthetics, and even sound quality is a lot better in the SRX. There's no denying that. It's a more expensive speaker. It's a better speaker. But to a regular DJ, to a regular audience that's not familiar with sound, they're not gonna notice, they're not gonna care. So I would say the sweet spot is still with the PRXs. The reason why I opted to get these is because I come from the nightclub world, so I like a punchy sound, and these give me that sound that I was searching for. And also, I play really, really, really loud. These speakers are freaking loud, and I love blasting my music because, like I always say, you ain't headlining unless you redlining. Thank you, bros, so much for watching this JBL SRX speaker review. Let me know what speakers you're using. Let me know what you think about them. Let me know if you own a pair of SRXs, and let me know what you think about them. You bros are freaking awesome. Thank you so much for watching this video. Like it, subscribe, and if you really want to help me out, don't forget to turn on that bell and share with all your friends on social media, Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, you name it. Please, please, please share. It helps these videos keep coming. Signing off, your boy, your homie, DJ Bar. Stay awesome, bros. Peace. Yeah.